Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Yes.
Bhartriwari ji has raised two or three issues. I'll address all of them. At the outset, he talked about the ordinances. I'm sure he'll appreciate the severe crisis and challenge before this government when the Honorable Supreme Court struck down the allocation of 204 coal blocks. Several of them, around 42 of them, were already producing or ready to produce. This government had the Hobson choice of letting them stop operation after 31st March.
Yes.
Thousands of people would have been jobless, some of them in his state also. There would have been a severe coal shortage, which the country is already plagued of, and therefore it was necessary to promulgate the ordinance in the first instance. The fact that the bill could not be cleared in the Rajya Sabha because of continuous disruptions is a matter before all the honorable members. His concerns for the state were also before the center, and therefore the government chose to promulgate the second ordinance when it could not be cleared. In a way, it also addresses Saugata Roy ji's question.
Yes.
When the house was disrupted repeatedly, therefore it was necessary to promulgate the second ordinance. Madam Speaker, the question on Section 7 that the Honourable Member has raised is a very important provision that is required for the central government, and none of the actions under Section 7 have been done arbitrarily. A technical committee comprising of interdepartmental officers, including the Department of Steel and DIPP, about which he has raised, have sat together and based on a defined criteria, which criteria, Madam, was also put up before the Honourable Court. The High Court is also seized of this issue, which was agitated before the court. And after listening to all sides, in respect of two mines, the Honourable Court has certainly suggested that the technical committee may reassess it.
Yes.
But otherwise, and those two are being reassessed by the technical committee. But other than that, the Honourable Court also appreciated this is a necessary provision to ensure that the large amount of shortage of coal in the power sector is quickly met. The power prices are kept at the lowest level possible and are not allowed to go into runaway increases. Therefore these mines have been allocated to the power sector, which is a regulated sector and affects 125 crore Indians. And therefore, to make sure adequate coal, adequate power at affordable price is available to all the states, therefore it was necessary to allocate them based on a defined criteria, Madam. I hope the member appreciates that his state is going to be a large beneficiary as more and more mines get auctioned and allocated. In the initial period, only those mines have been allotted and allocated which have already come into production or are getting ready. I think there are a lot more mines which will continue to be auctioned, where his state will also gain a significant amount of revenue. It is the initial mines which had already opened.
Abhi discussion nahi ho raha.
The initial mines had already opened and were in production. It is unfortunate that Odisha did not have mines which are already in production.
Yes.
Therefore, it may seem that his state has got less mines. Going forward, there will be more and more mines coming out. But the technical committee, on a defined criteria, based on the requirement of different sectors, the non-regulated and regulated, has done a sincere effort to protect the interests and requirement of all sectors.
Yes.
If we had only continued with what was done in the past, the allegation would have been we are a part of the continuing problems or the irregularities with the earlier Supreme Court judgment that struck down. Thank you.